Father, while your angels protect those who hear my voice, let them be loved, protected, see the worth and value to your divine name. It is 5:27 in the morning. Good morning. How you doing? You doing all right? You saying, why you doing? Why am I up so early? It's not even 5:30 in the morning. Because I'm here to tell you, you matter. And today is Friday. You're in the threshold of your weekend, and it's going to be so beautiful. I wanted to beat you. I wanted to beat you before you started your day. Pass this message on to you. So how you doing? You doing all right? How was your week? I hope it was stress-free. But I hope that whatever challenges that you had, that you were able to sidestep and navigate through them, because you're worth it. You're worth it. So I'm up this early because, for one, he woke me up, and I'm grateful every day, because you know you're not guaranteed that. So I always give praise to that, because every day that you are able to step into your life is another day to master yourself, to attract the things you need and dispel the things that are only wants, because you see your value. You see how precious and priceless your life truly is. And you should smile. You should be proud of yourself, because where you're coming from, where you've been, is not where you are now. And this is only a speck of comparative to where you're going to be, because of the person that is awaiting for you. That person, they're smiling, they're happy, they're in the life that you feel here and validated here. But we all got to do the work, right? We all have to master the things that are required for our evolution as a spiritual being on this earth. So I made him a coffee this morning. Cheers. And I felt compelled to put this out to somebody, because when I woke up, the Holy Spirit, he touched me to convey this message. So this is to you. First of all, know this: your prayers must go up so your blessings can come down. And each time that you take it upon yourself to find that place where you feel safe emotionally, spiritually, and physically to convey your thoughts, they're never in vain. They're heard. But the trick is being patient. But just know, the things that are being revealed today were manifested yesterday. And the things that you wish to come to pass will be revealed in the divine time. That is why it's called growth. That is why it's required for you to be still. That is why it is required for you to be you. Yes, we are to look at our brothers and sisters, our fellow man, for inspiration and motivation. But it is us that will do the work. It will be us that will learn the lesson that has been shared through the experience that binds us together, hopefully through love, compassion, and kindness, each one teach one. But it only can be truly understood when we go within ourselves. It's time for you to go in yourself. It's okay. Because when you decide to go inside yourself, you will see something within you that is so powerful, so divine, only for you. And it is called love. So do not hold on to the shackles that are only made of fear. They're only presented by illusions of what society wants you to think and not what you need to do. Just know that when setbacks come into your path, it is meant for you to be still and be prepared for the setup. Because you're loved. Don't you see that? That is why, in some instances, you see things play out. That's why some people, it seems like a movie to you, because you're like, no matter where you've gone, no matter what you've done, they're still there. They're still connected. They're connected to you for a reason. But it is your steps that define why. So, what I'm trying to convey to you is this. It's time for you to give yourself credit. No, I'm not saying it as taking a position of conceit. No, I'm not. But what I'm saying is, there had to be a level of bravery for you to do what you've done. Just make sure that whatever it is not a moment that is lost, not a moment that is in vain, or a second in regret. Because your purpose here, your life, your legacy, it's not a mistake. And when you come to realize, the more and more that you fight against yourself, that's when 9 times out of 10 the problems usually reveal themselves. Because we attract what is found in our heart. So why don't we take some of that negativity away? Why don't we take all the negativity away and start putting some love in there? Stuff it in there. Get it in there like an old glove box in a favorite car. Fill it to the brim with love. And I guarantee you, your reality will be made new. And speaking from personal experience, y'all, because at one time I was that way. I had that perception and how wrong I was. See, when you decide to truly invest in yourself, I know somebody's saying, well, Gerald, I heard this before. Maybe this message is for you. I'm telling you this. I'm conveying this message because it's time for you to fly. It is time for you to walk in faith and not by sight. It's time for you to let go of the negative umbilical cord that has had you bogged down for oh so long. It is time for you to look at those things that you consider deemed courage and claim them for what they really are, emotional baggage. And one by one, as you look through everything that has challenged you, you don't have to have a solution, but you've got to have the strength to look at them. The closer your resolution and revelation will come to pass. So, are you going to love yourself today? Are you going to start investing in yourself? See, that is the definition of being selfless, not selfish. Because if you don't take care of yourself, you're allowing boundaries to be exposed and letting your environment do it for you. And that is where conflict comes. You're not supposed to do that. That is why you have that beautiful smile on your face that only wants to reveal itself to the world. Listen, If you have something that you hold dear that no one knows, that you've been dealing with, give it to him. Give it to your higher power. I know him as my Lord Jesus Christ, but I know I am humbled because I know he is one of many names. And what I do know is there's no mistake. You are loved. You are loved from above as well as in your environment. But it's still your responsibility to discern it. That's where your clarity will come from. You know how they say, anything that is not worked for has no worth. So, when are you going to start working on you? Huh? Because you're valuable. Each and every one of you. Don't worry about what's going on right now. Don't worry about the people that don't want to be in your life. Actually, thank them. Because you'll come to realize they didn't see your worth. And at that moment, they weren't in a position to grow. However, divinely, it is up to your higher power to define if that chapter is closed. You do understand. A lot of times we think that we have control over our lives, and we find so much turmoil when it does not go the way we wish. What you're seeing is your higher power letting you know as subtly as possible that you're not in control. That is why you keep seeing the things you see, because it is required for you to complete the task. Your revelations on the other side. Or as I like to say, what is blocking you is your fear, but your blessing is on the other side. And you deserve it. Some of you have worked and worked and worked and worked and worked and worked. And you're at the point that you just want to give up. The devil wants to convince you, like, nah, see, hard work don't pay off. And you almost teetering because you're about to lose patience within yourself. You're feeling like, well, why don't I settle? No. I'm here to tell you this. You keep doing what you need to do. Do not worry about your environment and the people that are in it. Because guess what? The people that truly have your best interest should also be doing the same thing. The love should be unconditional. And they should want the best for you. Even if it means they must step away. But guess what? If it's divinely meant, you'll see him again at the right appropriate time and moment. But the difference in with that is, guess what? You're like-minded. You guys are on point. So don't worry about that, because that's a pure bone. But it is our responsibility, each and every one of us, to grow. You do understand that. Are you ready to step into your life? You're ready to claim the things that are rightfully yours, because when you took your first breath, it was a sign to your name. Just as much as your burdens. I think somebody wanted to hear that or needed to hear that. What I'm trying to tell you is this. Spring is here. Now you are supposed to step into your own with your head up high. Be proud of where you've been and look forward to where you're going. But love yourself all the time. Because you deserve it. You deserve it. See, every time you take a breath, you pay dues to be you. And yes, sometimes it's going to feel like it sucks. But that ain't nothing. That ain't nothing but that devil trying to convince you not to step into what's rightfully yours. Sometimes the devil will even send people in there to sway your judgment or your viewpoint at that moment. I say to you, go deep. Go deeper Go and tap into that spirit that is only yours and truly declare what is important to you. And if it feels like you're pulling teeth, because there's a difference between pulling teeth and pulling growth out of you. That's what maturity is all about. But what divides the two is, one is governed by faith, and the other is governed by environment. So to love yourself more. Okay? So, I'm not going to chitter-chatter. I got this coffee that I'm about to enjoy. And actually, I'm writing a paper, too. Put a little tweaks here and there. But I want each and every one of you to take this day, if you have not done it. Take a second. Tell yourself you love yourself. Think about the things that you're proud of, that you've accomplished, and look at the things that you thought was challenges, and look at the things you've done to surpass them purely. Give yourself credit. But also have the same credit of having courage to look at those at this moment that may have been your destruction. Do not have any ill will. Pray for them. Because prayer works. It truly does. So, I hope you have a beautiful Friday, because it's going to be warm. Step outside and get some of that good old sunshine from above. Take a second to reflect. Enjoy this day. Don't claim that negativity. Sidestep it at all costs. And sometimes, really, it's also good to just be still. Or better yet, when's the last time you took yourself out on a date and did something that you have longed to do? Make this weekend the weekend that you invest in yourself, y'all. When you decide to do that, everything else that is proclaimed for you to come in your life and be a part of your legacy will come. It will fall in proper perspective in the right time and moment. Why? Because it's yours. I think somebody needed to hear that. So don't worry about the small talk and chitter chatter. If you're going through something financial, pray on it. That ain't nothing but a distraction, but while you're praying on it, think, pray for a solution and watch what comes out. You're not a mistake. You never was. The mistake is not loving yourself more. So, I hope you have a great weekend. Enjoy it. There's many, many, many more to come. And I'm telling y'all, this is going to be one of them hotter than July summers. So, get your bug spray and your suntan lotion ready, because it's going to be fun. All right, y'all. Enjoy your day. As I always say, God is praying for you. You know I am. I see your worth. And for that, it helps me discern mine. You guys do not realize how protected, blessed you guys are. Put that smile back on your face where it rightfully is. You deserve it. All right, guys. Stay blessed. Bye.